In this video, we're going to talk about variables of time. We're going to explain what this variable is, how to use it, and explain the way it behaves in your functions. We're going to start the bot. At the moment, we already have one additional slot for the variable, so we don't need to purchase it. Thus, we're just going to add one variable of time. For this, we go to admin, variables, time, and create variable. We're gonna give it some name and send it to the bot. Variable is created, so now we can move to the main menu and show its default value in the message of the main menu. As usual, we go into the post editor and edit already existing message. This is how our new message will look like. We have added the macros of our newly created variable, and let's send it to the bot. As you can see, in opposed to the text variables, the variable of time has its default value. The default value for the time variable is time now, but we have to mention that this is a system time, and the time this variable will show is not correlated to your bot's time zone. This time will always show UTC plus 3. In this way, you need to understand that your bot has two different times. One is the system time, the one you're gonna use for your functions to measure the time gaps and make the timestamps. Because whenever you change the time zone, it will not deviate the time in your functions. And the second type of time you have in your bot is the regular time, the one you show with the macros like date and time. The time you will see using those macros is gonna be the one you use in your bot, and it will show the time of your time zone, the one you set in the admin settings. Newly created time variable is not initiated, so it will always show the current time. Before you can use this time variable properly, you're gonna have to initiate it. It can be done by the functions you create in your bot or by the action of initialization. We're gonna talk about those things in a separate videos. So how are you gonna use the time variable in your bot? Time variable can store certain timestamp, and as long as you have it, you can count the time gaps in the future or in the past according to the time saved in this variable. More information you can find in a dedicated manual about how to work with date and time. This video will conclude the conversation about the variables. We have spoken about all four of them.